old church, school, probably both.
International Climate Treaty, Christopher Jones.
Station. Lee vs. Grant, 1864 campaign. A greater sense of loss and deeper grief never followed the death of mortal man, reported one of Jackson's men. I rejoice that Stonewall Jackson's death is a gain to our cause, wrote Union General Gouverneur Warren. Yet in my soldier's heart, I cannot but see him the best soldier of all this war and grieve his untimely end. How we doing?
Fine, how are you?
I'm good. Is it okay if I shoot some video?
Certainly can.
What's your name?
My name is Randy Washburn.
Brad Lockwood.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. Well, I just wanted to come out to this site. I'm a Yank, but a big fan of Stonewall. Big man?
About my height, maybe a little heavier.
Okay. Was that his only injury of the war?
He was slightly wounded at 1st Manassas, got hit in the finger.
Okay.
It wasn't any type of disabling wound.
Peculiar man.
Very.
Went into war, one arm raised to keep the blood and...
keep his organs aligned.
So, sucking on lemons?
Well, that's partially true, but probably. I think that's grown into a myth.
Okay. It's hard to parse that.
If you go to his grave site in Lexington, people will still throw lemon slices.
Will they really?
Yeah.
Is his arm with him?
No, his arm is buried on the wilderness battlefield.
Oh, boy.
Near where the field hospital was.
Okay, I heard that they're building a Walmart right at the wilderness.
It's been approved.
Oh, boy.
They haven't broken ground yet, but the fight's still on.
Boy, what he would have done at Gettysburg, huh?
That's the eternal question. The two rooms up there were used as sleeping quarters by members of his staff. You can go up there if you'd like.
It sure as heck wouldn't have been a Pickett's charge.
Certainly would have been thought differently.
Yeah. Are you a fan? Did you pick this location or get assigned or?
No,
I wonder what the attraction is about him.
Well, the eccentricities are one of the attractions. course, I think the fact that he died during the war probably made him, at least at that time, more popular than Robert E. Lee. Lee, of course, survived, whereas Jackson didn't, so he kind of symbolizes the forlorn hope of the Confederacy.
Yeah.
Huh. He's probably the greatest figure of the Confederacy who did not survive the war.
After he got shot in the arm, this is where he was brought?
Yep. He had the arm amputated at a field hospital on May 3rd, and then the next day he was brought here.
And that was Chancellorsville, where he got shot. By his own men, probably?
Yes, in the dark. He was taken by, well, stretcher and eventually ambulance wagon to a field hospital near the Wilderness Tavern. The arm was amputated here. His corps chaplain was nearby. The chaplain's brother owned Elwood, or the Lacey House. So instead of seeing Jackson's arm buried in a mass grave, the chaplain took it over to Elwood and buried it in a family cemetery, and that's where it stayed. Then in the early 1900s, one of Jackson's surviving staff officers placed a number of granite markers in the area, mostly related to Jackson.
Okay.
There's one out front here, and this one says the arm of Stonewall Jackson. It's the only one in that cemetery.
Good man. I think I saw his table. Is that at Gettysburg, the table where they actually did the amputation?
He got here about 8 o'clock at night, and was brought into this building on a stretcher.
Okay.
Carried directly into this room. And laid on the same bed that's sitting there today.
Oh, boy.
That bed frame is the same one. The other two items in the room that were here at the time were the folded blanket at the end of the bed and the clock was brought in when he was here. Everything else in the room is an antique from that period.
Now, was it gangrene?
No, actually it was pneumonia.
Okay.
For the first couple of days, they thought he was going to recover. He was showing signs of it, but then he woke up in the morning of the 7th in severe pain, sick to his stomach, and having difficulty breathing.
Yeah.
And that's when Dr. McGuire made the diagnosis of pneumonia, and they began to treat him for that, but the treatment was pretty primitive, and the addition of a wound or an amputation certainly reduced his chances of survival.
They weren't like leeching him back then, were they?
Well, they bled him.
Did they?
Yeah.
Oh, God. Can you imagine?
But he would die on that bed at 3:15 in the afternoon on May the 10th.
Old rope bed too, huh?
Mm-hmm.
I have but to show him my design, and I know that if it can be done, it will be done. With Stonewall gone, Lee would never again achieve the success he gained at Chancellorsville.
Is that the actual, did anybody try to dig it up and just find an arm?
Twice. Twice that we know of. Once in 1864, Union soldiers did it when occupying Elwood. And then they were ordered to rebury it. And then in the 1920s, a Marine Corps general had some Marines with him. And being a general, decided that he could do anything he wanted. So he ordered his men to dig it up to see if it was there.
Oh, no.
Apparently, they found it and then reburied it. And he placed this plaque on the stones, no longer there, but we still have the plaque.
It's good to be a general, right?
Not in those days, because you were close to the action.
But during the battle, I was reading out there, pretty simple. He didn't want to stay in the house, pitched his own tent.
Right. Well, yeah, he was out here on this property during the wintertime, and Mrs. Chandler tried to get him to stay in the house. But he politely refused, and then she tried to bribe him with a couple of meals, and he politely refused those as well.
Huh.